One thing I think I'd like to say, and you could maybe even start the whole shit off with this, is I'm not sorry for making this album. And I made this album from a place in my heart of love. And I'm black and I'm proud of shit. That's the shit, that's the thing the whole world told me I could never say or be or do. And I'm biracial. And I love my fans. Swag flex, rap back.
Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now.
Come on. Is it going? All right, what's up, guys? This is day one of recording for the, hey, what's up, guys? Make sure you keep that last part in there and me explaining it because, you know, I'm real all the time right back. And my studio is being built.
Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's hammer in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, motherfucker, run. Put a po-po, get the gun, put it to your brain like goddamn. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live without it. Red light, stop. Green light, go. Everything ain't what it seemed like. Motherfucker, I know. Hold up, what you mean? Where you been? Bitch, I've been in. This is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? A box under the bridge like Anthony Kiedis. Looking for something to complete us and maybe lead us. Fucking the leaders. Hell of a long way from equalist how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people. Everybody bleed. Everybody need some. Everybody love. Everybody know how it goes.
What are you gonna contribute?
That was the first song ever created in this room.
Yeah, that was the first beat ever. Damn. But like, what's it like from going to what's gonna be in here from Charles Hall?
Oh, nuts! This is the come up, the glow up. That's what we always wanted.
Oh well, the message for the music is just equality of man, straight up and down. 6 o'clock. When white people find out that I'm black, racist white people, they treat me awesome. Like, and I've heard this: send your ass back to Africa. At least the half that matter doesn't matter. Shit like that I've heard. It's like, that's what I am. I'm either one or the other to these people, you know? There's like just a handful, no more than I think 4 songs, where I'm truly discussing being biracial in America. With that being said, those are the only times I discuss race. And it's my race. It ain't your race or his race or her race or this. It's just me being biracial, telling my story. And you might not like my story, but it's my story, you know? And then the entire rest of the album is wrapped, you know, from different perspectives of the life that that dude, Adam, who's being reincarnated, has lived.
There's a guy who dies in the beginning of this album, and his name is Adam.
Adam, but like the first man, right? But spelled A-T-O-M, like the atoms in our body and everything connecting us.
He gets hit by a car, and he wakes up in a white void, and he's talking to this random guy.
And the guy's like, life, what's it all about? And he's like, what the fuck are you talking about? He's like, where am I?
Well, it turns out that the random guy is actually God.
Have you ever heard of this guy named Neil deGrasse Tyson?
Scientist.
Mm-hmm. Astrophysicist, crazy, super awesome.
And I don't know how the hell I did, but I got him to play the role of God on my album, which is crazy.
I can't even believe that Neil deGrasse Tyson is on this album. Like, when I think about it, that's like the most gangsta feature of all time.
So, what now? I mean, what advice can you give me?
What advice can I give humanity, you mean?
You guys know Big Von? Mm. He's like the radio DJ from the Bay. Like,
Oh, yeah.
So he plays this guy named Adam.
Wait, what? Stop all the hippie shit.
This guy Adam dies, and then it's a whole conversation between them.
And he finds out that he's about to be reincarnated.
And then he finds out not only that he's being reincarnated, but that he is everybody who has ever been reincarnated, because there's only one human being.
And that he has been reincarnated so many times, in fact, that he is every human being that has ever existed.
You know, he was Jesus and all of his disciples. He was Hitler and everybody that he murdered. You know, every time he extended a hand of kindness to someone, he was doing it to himself. Every time he extended a hand of hatred or murder to someone, he was only doing it unto himself.
And it isn't until he has lived in the shoes of every man, woman, child, race, religion, color, creed, and sexual orientation that he will know what it is to appreciate life and then be taken to the next plane of existence.
So every time I'm rapping on the album, pretty much, I'm rapping from the perspectives of one of the lives he has lived.
So it's very sci-fi, but it's very real. It's weird, man. It's a good one.
Hip-hop artists are tasked to not have imagination, but to actually work in direct correlation to where they're from, who they were, and, you know, he has a lot of imagination.
I was actually inspired when I read a short story that was written by a writer by the name of Andy Weir called The Egg. I read it, and it inspired me so much, and it's essentially the same thing, it's just my take on it. You know, it's a man who dies and is reincarnated and lives every life ever. And I thought, wow, I relate to more than just one sect or one side of humanity or race being biracial. I kind of feel that. I feel kind of what it's like to be two people, to be like a black man in a fair-skinned body, if that makes any sense. So it's like, wow, it's almost like living two separate lives to the public, not to me, but to others. They might view me as different people. I guess, wow, it's crazy. I never really thought about it like that.
So bringing who he is into the stories that he wants to tell and having them intertwined with reality and fantasy, sci-fi, that's a difficult thing to score.
I didn't think I was gonna be able to pull it off. How do you pull off that? How do you pull off an album rapping from different perspectives of a life that one man lived who is actually everyone ever? It's just crazy, but I don't know how the hell it came together, but it did. I'm like, hallelujah,
praise God. This is so much more than just music. It's like a true personal part of my life. So I'm getting my license. I'm trying to do my best to get fit and in shape and deal with being mentally healthy and physically healthy and dealing with my music and friends and wife and personal relationships and dogs and everything. So I just want you guys to see as much as of my life. So yesterday, I think I was telling Mike, yeah, that I had like the wildest anxiety ever. In my mind, I was like, I'm fine. I'm like, I'm fine. I don't know why, because I was physically feeling weird, but not like ill or anything, just like faint, you know, kind of dizzy, kind of out of it, very disconnected.
What's up, dude?
Nice, I got an appointment. What's your name?
Raymond.
Nice to meet you, Raymond.
Nice to meet you. Have a great day.
Thanks, brother.
Yeah, that's a big thing that I've been dealing with so much is like anxiety. And a lot of people don't understand it, and that's why I'm having you document this right now, because I want to invite everybody into my life like never before, and I have severe anxiety, and it's hard, and it sucks. So crazy because I've always, like, I'm on my shit, you know what I mean? Like, I'm on my shit and I know what I need to do, I know how I need to do things, but then anxiety can step in and be like, oh, you feel up to having this meeting or this conversation or going on stage or performing or this or that, but I'm gonna fuck you up. Like, it's crazy. And so anxiety is so much more than just mental. It's a mental thing that can affect you physically, and that's why when I first had like the biggest panic attack I ever had last year, you know, just after The Incredible True Story was made, I was convinced I was going through a physical thing. I was convinced that it was something deeper, like I had fucking cancer or something, you know what I mean? Like, because my body was so fucked up. It's not that. It's my mind, it's anxiety.
Should I do this tonight?
How do you know?
Everything's good, everything is fine. I ain't got nothing on my mind. I'm good, I'm good, I'm good.
That's dope.
I'm good.
I wish you were. When I went in the booth and I knew all of you guys were all out there listening and I was learning it there and then on the spot what he wanted me to sing, yeah. My legs were shaking. I was so nervous. It was the first time I sung it. And I guess that's when you really, like, I realized that he's got a vision and I have to trust it, because I wanted to practice it and get better at it and then come back in. And he was like, I want to capture how you are right now when you're singing it for the first time.
I think that's good. Wow.
That's the first in my life I've ever done something like that.
You never?
I'm not really sure how it goes. Now, listening back, I really understand why he wanted to do that, because there's a vulnerability to what was captured that I don't know if that would have been the same if I'd learned it.
But sometimes.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? Because then it hits sometimes. You sometimes. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, sometimes. Then just end right on the.
But sometimes.
I'ma get up in your mind. I'ma get up in your mind right now, like.
Woo!
cool. Let's go. I'm gonna fuck with the rap. I'm gonna get up in your mind right now. Make you feel like dying right now. Come here innocent and vibe right. Pray to God for a sign right now. Like, woo! Damn, this is gonna be really special. Holy shit. Again.
Go, get up! Get up. I'ma make it someday somehow, what you're telling yourself. But you ain't focused on what's important, mentality help. Everybody in the world only want one thing. What's that? Infinite power in a pocket full of wealth. It's
like,
yeah.
Yo, making music makes me feel good, man. Like when I'm here with you guys, like not just in any type of way, a lot of that, I mean, I still be feeling weird, but a lot of it goes away. It's like I have purpose with you guys. Like here, it's crazy,
Hold
man.
Hold on, wait, I'm trying to think. One second. Should it end with the hook?
Yeah, or maybe that's not the hook. Maybe I keep going right now and then I bring the hook again. That's what I'll do. I will extend this verse.
I'ma hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. I'ma hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. But I'ma hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. No, I'ma hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. No, I'ma never giving. And I'ma look.
God damn it.
I'ma hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. No, I'ma never giving. Cause I gotta know. I'ma hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. I'ma never giving. I gotta let them know I'm in them.
There we go.
I'ma bring it back to the real now. Living innocent and real now. Motherfucker, I'm in the field.
It's always really hard to recreate a vibe. Cause I was in such a great zone the other night. I have to tap back into that same energy. It's gotta be the same.
I'ma get up, get on. That's what I've been on. Fucking with your mind, but I'm really trying to hit on life and give you something to sit on, something to ponder, living to honor. I'ma get up, get on. That's what I've been on. Fucking with your mind, trying to turn sit on. But they wanna pit me as a villain, even though I'm here to open their mind through the rhyme of life. And now I gotta make the decision to get in them like an incision. Ooh. To make a decision, it went. Make a decision. Fuck, man, make a decision to get in them like an incision. I'ma hit them and get them. Woo! All right, again. Goddamn, it's gonna be crazy. Again, no! All right, can you pause it? I fucking hate technology. Pause it. All right, can you run back with the last shit I was doing? My phone deleted all the shit, please. I fucking hate this shit. I make a decision to get in, I'm like an incision, cause I'ma hit them and get them living when, woo, again.
I gotta go quicker, okay, here we go.
I'ma make a decision when the fuck, again. God damn it, man.
Sorry. If I sound any type of way, just energy, man. I'm just trying to get it, man. I think this is harder than when I did gang related.
Make a decision to get in. I'm like an incision because I got to hit him. Make a decision to get in. I'm like an incision. I'm going to hit him. Again. Make a decision to get in. I'm like an incision because I'm going to get him and get him. Fuck. Again. Because I'm going to hit him. Make a decision to get in. I'm like an incision because I'm going to hit him and get him living. They wonder what I'm giving. I'm going to never give him. Fuck. Again.
Oh, fuck. Come on. Please.
I make a decision to get in. I'm like an incision because I'm going to hit them and get them what I'm living. They wonder what I'm giving. I'm never giving. I got to let them know I'm in them life. Make a decision to get in. I'm like an incision because I'm going to hit them and get them living. They wonder what I'm giving. I'm never giving. I got to let everybody know I'm in their mind right now. Woo!
Let me hear that.
Make you feel like dying right now. I'm going to make you pray to God to the good old Lord for a sign right now.
So I need you to bring it back so it sounds really good, you know? You gotta make my vocals pop, period. Cause, you know, when I'm going here and this breaks, like, you gotta be able to feel it in your soul, you know what I mean? Like, as an engineer, you need to know what you're doing.
One more thing, what's that?
You know what I'm saying? So it's gotta be really good.
I lost my job at Bart Simpson.
Yeah, you're fucking out, bro.
I was with no ID yesterday. I hadn't seen him for a while. We just had a real good talk as men. And shot some pool.
We play pool. We shoot pool. I just won 3 games today.
He's going to edit that out.
No way. That's right.
You're going to CGI.
It doesn't matter. When you edit this, just know 3-0.
And then out of nowhere, and then I played him my album. He loved it.
My thoughts are it's to me, by far, is far his best work. For me.
And I asked him if he would rap on it. And he said yes.
I mean, I can rap.
So no ID's gonna rap on my album. Which is like, what? That's so unheard of.
You know, I probably haven't really recorded a song in 20 years.
I texted J. Cole and I was like, yo, Dion's rapping on my album. No ID. And he was like, what? He's like, how the fuck did you get him to do that? And I was like, I thought about it and I was like, I just asked him. He's like, only you. He's like, only you could get me to rap.
I've waited for this moment for a long time. Just to, like, be in here, nothing else matters, just working on music, that's it, with Dion. concept of the entire song is how we're all immigrants and what's going on in the Native American community that's being ignored.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now send the blacks back to Africa. Build a wall for the Mexicans. Send the whites back to Europe. Get a land to the Native American. Take the skyscraper. Tear down the casino. Print your own paper. And bear down on the green gold.
Fight the power, fight the power. Fight for the right to get up and say fuck white power.
So America came together where, I mean, y'all were there. That shit was crazy. I just found these like sample packs or like little things and like vocals, and I just started pressing them and I'm throwing drums on and creating the pads.
Woo! What the fuck is that? Where is that come from? Oh, it's from there. Woo! Woo! This is crazy.
When I create music, I hear sounds. I hear like a distinct, that's why all my shit, man, when you go to the festivals or whatever, they sing all the words because I make sure everything is catchy. All the sounds I use are catchy. And when you, the first thing you hear, woo, that's like, oh, when you hear that shit, like it goes off. What the fuck?
You'll hear a switch up and then I'm rapping. I'm just like rapping from just like a hood motherfucker and that's all he knows. And I guess that's a lot of like my own experience, like with my brothers and all the shit that I saw there. And then my boy Lenny is helping me like voice this character. You'll hear it.
Dope in the trunk, creeping out the cut. Now I'm by the gut, never get enough. I don't give a fuck. Stupid motherfuckers move backwards. Master the hustle. Something in the duffel for you bastards.
When Logic approached me with contributing to the song America, he laid it out. He knew what he wanted. So he gave me the inspiration, like told me exactly what he was going for on that part of the song.
We worked on the first album. I was the executive producer. And some of the first sessions in to the album, I pretty much knew that he was a producer and not just a rapper. And I pretty much told him, hey, you know, you don't really need me to produce your records because you have your ideas. You just need to, you know, have access to the personnel and the techniques to deliver your thoughts.
It starts out with Six and Logic, like the exact same way that they did it on the mixtapes. And every, mm-hmm. like, there's nothing has changed from that. No. You know, like, just these two guys sitting in the house, not in the big studio, not even down here, not anywhere special, just the two of them sitting down with the laptop, a concept,
mm-hmm.
and some kind of an inspiration. Yeah.
What's so crazy too is like you said, we're doing the same process as we did back in the day, but like we didn't have the string players and we didn't have the vocalists, you know, like that's what's really crazy about it. The process is still the same, but now we get to involve actual real musicians rather than me trying to sample a string part from another song because I can't play it. But now I can be like, you know, we have Claire and Tom to actually play the shit.
Watching Vaughn do the skits. Very entertaining.
What the fuck you mean if that's what I want to call it? Either it is what it is or it ain't. So either this is what it is or this is what it ain't. If it is what it is, if it is what it ain't. Yo, come in, guys. Come on, guys.
I got Neo on the album. You know how crazy that is? Space, time, and all the good things like that. Man, Logic has come up with the crazy story of all stories. All
right. So I was in Paris.
Yeah, yeah.
With my wife at the Louvre.
So this all started last summer when I get a call from Bob and I pick up the phone and it's 3 a.m. and I say, Bob, what's up, man? Like, what the fuck is this? And he's like, dude, I'm in Paris. I'm at the Louvre and I know what our album is gonna be.
Everybody's looking at the Mona Lisa. And I'm looking at the Mona Lisa and I'm like, damn, this is beautiful. Like Leonardo da Vinci painted this shit. Like, whoa, this is crazy. But then I'm looking at myself included. Everybody's just so focused on the Mona Lisa, but I'm in this insane museum with all this beautiful,
right.
You know, these statues and paintings and all different types of stuff. And I was like, I'm going to look for something. else, not just focus on this. And I turn around, and as soon as I turn around, I see this. Now, this is called The Wedding at Cana. It's where Jesus turned water into wine.
Wow, it's colossal.
And I was like, dude, doesn't that have like 100 people in it? And he's like, yeah. He's like, yeah, dude, it has like over 100 people. He's like, I don't know if we need that many, but like close. And I was like, I want you to paint all of them. I want it to be all my friends, all my family, everyone that works on this album, people of all races, colors, creeds, sexual orientations, and genders. I want it to be representative of everybody. Early into the year, I decided I wanted to go to Italy to get inspiration for this, where I had done all of my research online, but like I combed through Google image search, I had studied, you know, countless books on the artist himself, as well as other artists in the period. But there's limits to that. And there's just something about it where I felt compelled, like I've always wanted to go to Italy. If there's ever a chance, like why not now? I went to every possible church I could, went to the Museo Borghese, saw the Caravaggios, like I just kind of immersed myself in everything that I've always loved and researched, and I brought it back and tried to put it into the cover.
And this is going to be my album cover.
You know, the album is told from a variety of perspectives, which is something that Bob loves to do, of kind of putting himself in someone else's shoes and taking on their struggles and successes and trying to see things through their perspective. And this album, like listening to it, just sonically completely disconnected from the art, I mean, it just kind of like executes that flawlessly.
Forever I just wanted to focus on the music. I didn't want to talk about race. I didn't want to talk about negative shit going on in the world, because I just wanted it to be happy and fun, and like about lyricism and raw shit and raps. I felt that I needed to make an album like this because me being black and white and feeling discriminated against by my own people made me feel like I need to talk about everybody who is discriminated against. So I didn't want to just go out and be like, oh, I'm biracial, but I look white and I this and that. I was like, nah, I'm gonna really talk about not only what's on my heart but what's on the hearts and minds of people all over the world who don't have the voice that I do.
I'm here with Patrick Starr in my studio, and I recruited him because he's amazing and he's awesome and he's a very sweet, kind person, an amazing businessman.
So
or
nice.
Or business queen. And no, but honestly, like he's just been so awesome, and he's such a great role model for so many people that I wanted to include him as a representative for the culture, for his culture, and just have him on the album and have him on the album cover. So I just wanted to thank you so much.
It's so dope. So dope.
I appreciate it. Thank
Hold
you.
Hold up, wait a minute. No, my mom been gone like, whoa, wait.
Yeah, that was pretty good. Bob, can I hear that one?
I see good people who like to make good music, and it's that simple. You know, it's like, hey, do you like what I'm doing? Do you like what I stand for? Like, oh, you like this message? You like this? Do you want to come play? Do you want to be a part of it? Yes or no?
So I'm flying this chick out from the Bahamas. When me and my wife went on our anniversary, her name is Paula.
Hi, I'm Paula McKeever, all the way from Nassau, Bahamas. Met Bobby, known as Logic as well, in the Atlantis Resort and Casino Hotel.
We were at the bar, like having a few drinks, and this chick was killing it.
I was singing Uptown Funk. Okay. So everybody was on the floor having fun. And
I was like up and I was like dancing, like with all these like older ladies and shit. It was like so funny.
She's dancing like funky dude.
But she, like her voice was like, she was like killing, she was like doing Whitney Houston songs and shit.
I told him, I said, come up on the stage and show them what you got. And he just went wild and crazy.
Oh man.
And I didn't know who he was.
After she was done, when she went to take a little break, I asked her if she'd be willing to come sing on my album. She was like, yeah.
I need you to say. To wash away my sins, I'm home. She ain't gonna be
there. If you're real, if you're out there for real, please explain to me, why do we suffer? Why do we die? And why do people who go against everything you ever seen?
Okay, we'll go to the next sound.
Yeah, you know.
Kev, I love what you did on that song. It's not gonna make it. We're gonna mute that sound.
We're gonna mute that sound. Thanks a lot for that. Nobody tell you how to do it
right. All right, so then let's split off. So you wanna take that up? You take that.
I'd rather be a different man in another world. Work for the man in my universe. Wonder what it feel like. Take flight. Mama told me everything gon' be alright. I mean, my life can't be alright. Couldn't think about it. Everybody running the world seem to be alright. Can you motherfuckers see alright? I mean, I need it. I want it. I gotta have it. Every day tragic. If you're from where I'm from, every day ain't magic. On this I know. I've been telling everybody I'ma give it a go. I know I've been never broke. Feel it in my soul. Oh, I know. Love it, I hate it. I made it, I did it, I live it. With a whole world looking at the boy like, whoa. Baptized in a
whole. So I just had a pretty crazy cry. Because I'm happy though. And I'm not trying to milk it or anything, but I just thought I should let you know. You know, I just I just in this moment. You know, I was listening to the song, I was listening to Anxiety, and I think about how hard it is to live with it, and but beyond that, just the song, it made me realize how many people are here, you know, how many people are in this house, and how blessed I am to have my wife and my dogs and my friends and music and fans, and I can't believe it. Because I didn't have anything growing up. I didn't have anything. And now I have everything I could have ever wanted. And just right now in this moment, I'm just so happy and blessed. So I just wanted to, just real quick, I'm not trying to milk it or anything. I just wanted to say that I can't believe it. I can't. It's like I woke up and it's all really here and happening, so I'm just really happy. That's it.
Yeah, so it switches between an ensemble and like a quartet sound.
Is there anything in between?
It's just the blend. Right. So it'd be crazy if we kind of went back and forth. Right?
We're at Warner Brothers. We're at the soundstage where they do all the scoring for films, and we're doing the album. And I'm excited. I feel like I don't belong here.
All right, Jeremy and Logic, let's go out.
All right, it's 3 o'clock, people.
Let's go.
Yeah, I just wanted to say this is fucking crazy. Like, I'm sorry. This is amazing, and you know, I know we're here to work, but like, I came from nothing. And
come over here. Get over here.
Yeah,
come on.
So to be able to be here today with you guys is like a very emotional thing. And it's this album is about the equality of all men, regardless of race, religion, color, creed, and sexual orientation. This is the fight for equality.
Yo, Bob, you know what's really crazy?
Making a beat on like Ableton or FL Studio. And then like seeing that shit like charted out and like noted on like,
yeah,
that's amazing.
Yeah, we just like,
isn't that crazy?
We're just like Neanderthals.
Yeah, and then, like, they take have, like, this the whole thing. Yeah, like, all the sheet music over for like what we sample
for everything.
I
My name is Bobby Smokey Hall. I'm legend. I'm the legend of hip hop go-go.
I'm here to see my son, Logic,
one of the hypest hip hop artists out there. He's just in his own zone.
He's got a string session going on right now.
Bobby was born for this environment. So yeah, I love it. Bobby has always been driven, even as he was a kid, you know. He was a leader, not a follower. He didn't follow, you know what I'm saying? He had his own, you know, he had his own way that he lived, you know. I took Bobby in the recording studio when he was like 15 for the first time, and he spit for like 45 minutes and nonstop. And the engineer and I, Rock, we just laughed and said that boy got bars.
You know when, like, you were talking to your mates last night here on the sofa?
Uh-huh. Wait, hold on.
And I was just, like, kind of listening in and trying to learn what you guys were talking about. And you were saying, yeah, we work with loads of people, but, you know, we fuck with Logic.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I was... Excuse me? You were like, you know what I'm saying? We fuck with Logic. We fuck with him. You know what I'm saying? We fuck with Logic. And I'm like, what are you talking about? I had no idea what that meant.
So when did that click for you, what that meant?
Oh, only like 24 hours later when I asked
him.
Did I ask one of you guys? I was like, what's that mean when you fuck, when you're fucking with, because I thought if you're fucking with someone, you're like fucking them up or something.
Yeah, this is a classic. This is a classic documentary moment. Right?
But Lucy, I got one better for you. Have you heard of what a fuckboy is?
Oh. Yeah, so that's Jess. You don't want to know this. Jess said before she met you, she was like, I just used, like, there was only like, I went out with a couple fuckboys. And I was like, what the hell is a is? I was like, is that just someone you have sex with?
That makes sense,
right? Yeah, like a fuckboy. And she was like, absolutely not. No, it's like, no.
No fuckboys.
She was like, that just is like a lame person.
Yeah.
Totally lame.
Mm. It's all so different.
Yeah. Well, we all.
But I fuck with Logic.
Yeah, we all fuck with you, Lucy Rose.
That's right. I've learned that. I fuck with you all.
I fuck with you, dog.
I fuck with you all. No, am I fucking with you?
It was a long ass time ago, and I'm in the studio with this motherfucker, and he brings this thing in, right here. He brings this in. I'm like, Dylan, what's that? He's like, oh, it's that OP1, bro, for sure. And I'm like, damn, that's crazy. Yeah, so I'm like, damn, that's so dope. He's like, oh, yeah, man, check it out. He's like doing all this shit. I'm like, oh my god, like I gotta have this. So I hop in the whip, I go. I drop the bread on this shit immediately. I come back, all I get out of it, all I had used it like for, I spent all that money, and I got the kick for like, well, and it's worth every penny.
But yeah, so this is rapped from the perspective of a rapper who, like, so the first half, it almost sounds like a sample, like all the vocals, but it's all myself, and it's he's saying, like, you know, I don't want to sleep all day and get up at night. I don't want to just, like, basically, like, he's not happy with the life that he's living because he's one of those rappers who's just focusing on, like, money and, you know, material possessions.
It's called Ink Black because one of the lines is, I'm not me, I'm who you want me to be. And he's rapping like, yeah, I got money and I got all this shit. I'm not a real trapper. It's all bullshit, but I'm making my money. Fuck you.
And he's basically like that personification of what it's rap, or like, you know, a gun toting fucking, you know, chain wearing, like, yeah, yeah, I rap. But deep down, he's not happy. But his raps are like, yeah, I am, and I'm this, and I got millions, and I ain't even this, and it's just kind of like a rapper who really isn't really happy with himself, but he's making a lot of money. So that's his song.
Dumbass motherfuckers, man, all on the gram, all on the Snapchat with the bullshit, nigga. Kill your motherfucking self, nigga. Kill your motherfucking self, nigga, and tell your bitch I said slop on my knob.
That's crazy. crazy. Yo, I'm gonna keep all this shit for the album.
Oh, they gonna love that. They gonna be like, oh, fuck.
So, we're here at Scotch Wednesdays. It's a little thing I do every Wednesday with my buddies as grown men. We shoot pool, drink scotch, play a little bit of jazz and Sinatra on vinyl over there.
Salud. Did you smoke a Jeffrey?
Burrito. Wait, wait, who are some other ones that you're really good at impersonating?
Tinashe.
Oh, give me the Tinashe, all hands on deck, go.
Oh, no. All hands on deck.
Yeah. Keep going.
All in the front, all in the back, just like that, like that.
Okay, swag, let's do it.
Boo-boo, you're gonna do great.
Give me a kiss.
You just totally left me hanging.
Oh, sorry, babe. I didn't see.
All right, babe.
Which means that,
hello, sir.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing?
You brought the whole...
Yeah, we brought the whole team. The whole team.
Oh, excuse me. Who's taking the picture from?
I'm upset that I did what I was supposed to do. That's the only thing I'm telling you, man. It's not like a... I can fail. I've failed before. I've failed many times in my life. It's not that. It's when you know you did it. You know what I mean? You know you did it.
We're at the DMV. Bob's taking his driving test for the second shot. And I'm a little bit nervous. A little bit nervous. And honestly, I know he can drive, but just these instructors take off points for the craziest thing.
Thank you. 29, I can go through here.
Alright, now turn that shit off for you.
Hey, but you got that license though.
Yeah,
you
got that license, dude.
Black Spider-Man, I wrote, first and foremost, it's just about stereotypes. I've been led to believe that I should be ashamed of who I am, and I'm not.
I ain't ashamed to be white. I ain't ashamed to be black. I ain't ashamed of my beautiful Mexican wife, as a matter of fact. I know you fucking with that.
Like, be you, man. Fuck everybody else. Just be you. And people are gonna hate. They hate on me. My message and my whole shit is peace, love, and positivity, and people hate me. Like, think about that. That's crazy. When you look at people, you see things. You see a black man, you see a Middle Eastern man, you know, you see there's people who are conditioned to look at people of color or brown people on an airplane and feel a little weird. And it's that's so fucked up, you know what I mean? And it's like, I hate that. People look at me and I go, oh, I'm a rapper. And they go, what? You know what I mean? Or people are conditioned to not accept me in hip hop because of how I look or how I speak, you know what I mean? Oh, you speak white or you talk white. What the fuck you mean I talk white? What the fuck? Like, no, I'm just saying in general, I've heard that my whole life, like in this career. Like, what do you mean talk white? What the fuck does that mean? I said, fuck that. Why can't Spider-Man be black? Why can't James Bond be gay? Why not? You know what I mean? Like, fuck it. You know, like, that's what I think. And that's why I open it up with Jesus, black Jesus. To people like, what? Black Jesus? What the fuck? Like, I got a black Santa Claus right now in my house. You know what I mean? Like,
Jesus. Black Jesus.
Ooh, that laugh. Remember that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hey, they're getting saved.
I've known Damien for 6-7 years now, maybe even 8 years. And we've just been buddies like through the internet. We used to do records together like when I wasn't shit, I wasn't nobody. I knew I wanted him to be on the album and he left everything to come out here with no promise of placement or this or that, just to see what he could contribute. And I'm sitting down there and we're working and it's the end. And I'm like, man, I think I need some vocals on here. And I'm like, just like I do, like I said, I trust everybody. Who knows what's gonna happen? Hey, you wanna go in there and let's see what you got. He told me that before Bobby hit record, he could hear in the microphone his heart pumping.
And like, I could just feel the magnitude of this moment and how pivotal it was.
He was like, it was 6 years in the making that just came out. And
something just kinda like hit me. I don't know, I just like started like really kinda letting loose. Something about that, some type of angelic being just kind of like grabbed me and just like let me soar vocally.
Praise him.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Yo, I'm putting this on the album.
Come in here right now.
I'm here.
That was great.
Oh, that was good.
You just earned yourself a feature credit.
Yeah, that was just like one of those milestones in your career where you just know like you're in the right room, you know, in the right mind state and everything just lined up.
I only work with people who are as good and creative as I am, but in their own field. I like when people make me feel fucking stupid. I like when people are so good at playing strings or piano or singing or whatever, they make me feel talentless. Like, I can't do what they do. I'm Batman, right? Straight up. I'm player one, all right? I'm Super Mario. But so are you guys behind the cameras. So is Six, so is this. Everybody is a player one. I don't work with player twos. I don't work with Robins. I work with other Batmen. And I know that sounds really weird, but what I mean by that is, you, when you leave and you take this camera and you go to do whatever you do, you're a boss. You're a boss and you go do boss shit. But when you're with me, you're under my wing, being a boss, helping me paint my boss ass picture.
I'm about to link up with Logic, going downstairs in the basement. It's my time to shine.
Hopefully I have something that actually like fit on the project.
Am I in trouble? You heard this?
When I first made the beat, I definitely, I could see him on this, cause he know, he loves to rap fast too.
Yeah. I don't know what I'ma do, I don't know where I'ma live, cause I feel like I ain't got nothing to give. Just wanna follow my dreams, just wanna follow my heart, but the world wanna tear me apart right from the start. Everything I ever wanted, it ain't what I thought. Bring it back to the roots, let my name Black Thought. This shit right here, no, it can't be taught. Gotta be learned, it gotta be.
I mean, he's a superior lyricist, we already know that. He knows how to put together a classic album, we know that. This is, it's beautiful, it's rich, it's moody. It revs you up and brings you down. It's an album. And in an age where that may not be important to everyone, it's refreshing, you know. So, bravo. Yeah. I've told him before, I think he's one of the best in the world.
Oh, man.
Real shit.
Come on. Thanks,
oh,
buddy.
I ain't got no time to lie. I ain't gonna tell the stripper she pretty. I just came for the ass, Lord.
Logic's music really makes me feel something. I don't listen to a huge amount of hip-hop or rap music. And when I first met Bobby, he did ask me, he said, why do you listen to my music? I don't understand. You like play this sweet folk music and then you listen to my music. But there's something about it which I can't explain, but it really makes me feel something.
It's just kind of scary. Because like when I first started making music, I did it and I was willing to sacrifice everything because I had nothing to lose. And now I have everything to lose. But that isn't a bad thing. That just means I have a good life. It makes me work harder because I was working as hard as I possibly could to attain all this. Now I have to work a million times harder to keep it.
Ooh, I just gave you some fire.
With my last album, I went around to a bunch of radio stations and I shook hands and I fucking jerked a bunch of people off and I was like, yeah, what's up? And trying to get radio placements, and, but not like trying to work for the radio, but like trying to get more people to hear. And but this time I'm like, man, fuck that shit. I ain't going nowhere. I'm not doing any press. This album has already done what it was intended to do, and it was set me free of any shame the public made me feel. It did what it was intended to do because I don't give a shit what anybody else thinks. And I'm not really gonna try to get too much into it, but I had a conversation with J. Cole about the public and being on social media and all these things. And it's like, I don't need anybody to accept me. I don't need anybody to tell me that my music is good or that I'm great or I'm amazing because I know I'm good, I know I'm great, and I know I'm amazing. Just like you and them. So fuck anybody else and what they gotta say. I know I'm good. And that's what this album is about, knowing that you're beautiful, you're great, you're amazing, you're special, you are something, we're something, will be something, so fuck everybody else.
I'm just trying to live my life. I'm just trying to do what's right. I'm just trying to get inside. I'm not trying to sleep all through the day and get
shit. That was lit.
Shit. At least we got good walking music. Or is that it?
Oh, no. I'm queuing up the fourth album now. His final one.